Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to this webinar, How to Work with the Map Content Blip for Piping App. Today, I'd like to introduce my colleague, Maarten Sonneveld, who's working as an international sales engineer for MEP Content, and myself. My name is Jaap Groem. I'm a product marketer.
Hello, and good afternoon.
Today, we'd like to introduce to you our new app, the Map Content Blip for Piping. This is a Revit app, and in this webinar, we'd like to explain to you how it works. If you have any questions, please do feel free to ask your questions. There is a question panel which you will find in the GoToWebinar menu. You can type in your questions here. We'll try to answer them during the webinar. If it's not possible, we'll have a Q&A session after the webinar where you can ask all of your questions. What will you learn in this webinar? Well, of course, we'd like to tell you a bit more, if you don't know this yet, about MEP Content and Stabiplan. And then we go deeper into our new app, the Blip for Piping app. This is an app for designing piping systems, as the word says, in Revit, with manufacturer-specific data. Maarten will give a demonstration of the app, so you get a good idea of how both the manufacturer branded and the generic blip will work in Revit. And after that, we'd like to go a bit more into detail on the benefits for manufacturers to publish their own app for Revit. And afterwards, as I just said, there's some room for questions. So yeah, MEP Content. If you don't know this yet, the main goal of our platform, mapcontent.com, is offering BIM content. And we'd like to offer this BIM content specifically to people working in the MEP industry. So this can be MEP engineers, designers, and modelers. And we try to offer you as many manufacturer-specific products on our platform as possible, because we know this will help you in delivering good BIM projects. We have about 30,000 MEP engineers on our platform, and this number is growing every day. We see a huge demand for BIM content. And this is the same case with the manufacturers. We now have almost 300 manufacturers on our platform offering content. And also this number is increasing. So we're very proud to already host more than 500,000 articles. And with these articles, we have a global reach. We have users from more than 60 countries all over the world. And this also demonstrates the increasing BIM adoption all across the world. BIM is a fact all over the world now, and well, we'd really like to help people to buy offering them quality content. And the quality of our content is guaranteed by our own standard, which is the EMCS. This will make sure that content has the good data, but is also usable in all projects. MEP Content is part of Stabiplan. Stabiplan is a company based in the Netherlands, Bodegraven. We have about 170 employees. And the main product of Stabiplan is StabiCAD. This is a design tool for the MEP industry based on Revit and AutoCAD. We have already more than 25 years, 27 to be exactly, years experience. And we offer tools based on software and data, which help engineers to design better projects. We have quite some offices already in Europe, and we're a growing company. So back to MEP Content. Here you see, if you type in www.mepcontent.com in your browser, you'll end up on this website. As you can see, the search bar is most important, because this is where you enter our search engine. And our search engine helps you to find the content you need for your project. And as I said, it's already more than 500,000 articles, so yeah, you can find almost anything you like on our platform. And if not, we're always open for requests and really happy to hear what else content you need. So I'd encourage you to have a look on the platform. Now, we have been offering content for quite a while. 3D content for Revit and AutoCAD. And these are all single products and articles which you can download individually right into your project. But we know there is a demand for engineers to not only use manufacturer-specific content in projects. Also, we know that our users like to have more speed and more efficiency when designing. You like to perform your task quicker and you like to do it more efficient. And this is why we recently started introducing apps. You see the apps we have hosted on our store now. And these apps are specifically designed for people working in the MEP industry and specifically designed to combine both manufacturer-specific data and Revit tools. So they combine the power of Revit with the manufacturer data. Some examples of these apps are the ABB Switch Range Configurator. This is an app for an electrical manufacturer, ABB, well known. And it helps engineers to really quickly create switch ranges for complete BIM projects. And it helps you to manage these entire series of switch ranges all over your BIM project. It's a really nice tool. You can download it for free, as well as the Map Content Browser. This add-in for both Revit and AutoCAD helps you to browse the Map Content platform from right within your project. So you never have to leave your project environment. You can just open it right from your browser and then start using the search engine and find the products you need. Also freely available. Then, recently added to our web store are the product line placers for piping. We started in March with the Sana product line placer. Sana is a well-known German manufacturer of piping systems, and they launched their first branded piping app. So the Sana app, and Maarten will demonstrate this later on during this webinar, helps engineers who work with Sana to really quickly design Sana piping systems. And these are these piping systems, which you are maybe used to designing first generic. You can now directly engineer specific piping system right in the Revit, equipped with correct article data, GTIN, URL. So you have all the data you need to order piping systems right from within Revit. So it's really it's a tool which helps you to design piping systems much quicker than you were used to with plain Revit. And a few weeks ago, we introduced the Map Content product line placer for Revit, because we saw that there was a huge demand for having manufacturer-specific data for piping systems right into Revit. So we bundled all of the manufacturers already on the Map Content platform offering piping products into one app, so you can really easily design with all these different manufacturers. You can also download this. We ask a little price for it. But you can have a look at our store and see how you can get the full app. Maarten, this is your time to give the demonstration. Ah, here you just see a sheet summarizing the brands which are in the PLIP and the main benefits.
Yeah, indeed. Jaap, well, thank you very much for the information. Yeah, as Jaap described in the last slide and in this slide as well, we have an app available to draw and design piping systems in Revit. He mentioned the one from Sana. That's a specific piping application. And there is a generic application where engineers can select different brands. In this webinar, I will also give you a live demo. So we will now switch to the Revit environment. And what you see here is Revit. So I have created an electrical plan and a mechanical plan, and today I will show you how to design some piping systems with the apps we just mentioned. If you go to the Revit ribbon, you will find the standard tabs here. As soon as you download a Map Content app, you will see the Map Content ribbon, and you will find the available apps. So today we zoom into the piping app. So I've installed the Sana app and the Map Content generic app. And when we open this app, you will see the following. Well, first of all, this app was specifically for Sana. So it's only possible with this application to design systems from Sana. Now, first I will go to the settings and show you a little bit of the background. It is possible in this application to select the country where you're in. Some manufacturers are offering different products in different countries, so they have different product ranges per country. It can happen that the piping systems which are available from Sana in the Netherlands are not the same as in Germany. So therefore, we made a selection of country-specific content, and engineers can select the country where they are in. If your country is not here, it's possible to select an international edition, and you will find the content which is available internationally. Also, it's possible to select a language. This is about the interface language, how the application looks like. Well, since we also have some English or foreign attendees at this webinar, we keep it in English. And it changed the interface language. All right, well, it was already set, so I don't have to save it. Of course, you have to create a Map Content account also to download this application. As soon as you have downloaded and installed this application, it only takes 2 minutes. And you need to log in with your Map Content account, and you can use this app for free. Well, as soon as you're logged in, download the tool and have set your language, it's time to start choosing a product line. Well, Sana has made several piping systems available in this application. As you can see here, they're offering all different kinds of systems. Well, of course, an engineer has to make the decision himself which piping system he's going to use. Today we will use the Sana NeroSan. And when you click a product line from the manufacturer, you will find different types. When you go to another one, you will find the several available products. Therefore, it's also possible to select a product group. Well, at first, we would like to start with designing a pipe, so a pipe system. And within this pipe system, we can also place couplings or fittings. We can choose them manually here, or we can automatically select them in the design. I will show you later on how that works. Also, it's possible to select a system. So in what kind of system is the piping, is the pipe type used? And you can preset everything here. Well, I already designed a small piece, but you can select the type you need, and you select the diameter you would like to have, and you can press OK, and it will retrieve all the latest data from the cloud. So the application is making a connection with the cloud server from Map Content, and it is retrieving the latest manufacturer data. So via this way, we make sure engineers are always working with up-to-date data, and all the data is still, it's active. As soon as a manufacturer passes through its changes or updates, we will make these changes in the database, and the engineer will automatically receive all this data. So when you select the pipe system, you can start designing. Well, what we do here, we just make a small, simple system. You can click here. It automatically creates the right fittings. You can change to a two different diameter, let's say 35. And it is automatically creating the system. Well, of course, you also would like to add a T or anything. As you can see here, it automatically adds a T. And very important is, it only creates systems which are available or can actually be bought in the Sana product range. So as soon as you are designing a system which is not available in the Sana piping system, Revit will give an error and it will say, hey, the system you are trying to design is not standard in the Sana product range. So please be aware, the thing you are designing, it probably cannot be bought in real. So that's very relevant to know. You see here now, I created some pieces, and it also automatically added T's, as you can see here. And on the right side, you will find the SANA data, like article numbers, cheating, what kind it is. Also, we have the 3D view here. You can also add a T or a coupling or anything else manually. You can select the pipe. You can select, I select the coupling in this case. You can select the coupling, female-female. You have to remember the incoming or outgoing diameter. Say OK. And you can place components wherever you like. Of course, this is not 100% correct, but it gives you an idea how the application works. And the same goes for the T. We can select the T, select the diameters, and also you will find the options which are still available. So I can select 45 or 54 branch diameter, but if I want a reducing T, I can also select another type, let's say 35, and I can place it directly in my model. The data has to be retrieved from the cloud, so sometimes that takes a minute depending on your connection, and you can place it directly in your model and start or continue with your design. Of course, when you have designed a complete installation, it is very interesting for you to know what is exactly in my system or what is exactly in my model. Therefore, we making use of Revit schedules. Here you find an overview of the SANA NeuroSound pipes, which I just used. And you will see I've used three different diameters. They're all the same type. And here you find the total length. So you know exactly how much you have to order at SANA. And of course, you also get an overview of the fittings which are used. And when you want to receive more information, there's also a deep link added to this URL. And that is if you need more information. My colleague is mentioning that we received a question. Let's see.
Yeah, Gideon is asking if you can show him the pipe sizing.
Pipe sizing. Can you specify this question for us, please? I just used the SANA NeuroSound. If I select this system, it automatically will show you the all available pipe sizes. So what I just did, I used the 54 diameter pipe, but I can also start designing with 35. And you can start designing as soon as you selected this this type. If you are in the model and you would like to change the pipe diameter, you can use the standard Revit functionality by changing the diameter in this way. And in this case, because the application has loaded the information from SANA, it automatically creates or puts the SANA reducing coupling in here. So if you have any other questions about this functionality or how this works, please let me know. But it's possible to work with different dimensions and different pieces. You can automatically use the T's, the couplings and everything, but you can also select the couplings manually. Now I will go on to the map content product line placer, which is the generic version of the PLIP, and this is available at map content for engineers. The difference between this application and the one from SANA is that SANA has developed this application specifically for his piping systems, and map content is also providing a generic version. Since many other engineers also would like to use other piping systems. Of course, SANA is also in here, but you have the possibility to select a manufacturer you like or you need, whatever. If you download this app and you're missing content, you can select this button and you go directly to the website where you can fill in some details and let us know which content you are missing. We try to offer a complete as possible product range, but of course it can happen that we are missing something, and therefore we would like to ask for your help. Well, in this case, let's use George Fisher. They have various product lines available. Let's use the new CoolFit system. Same here for as a generic clip, pipe, bends, everything, system types. Also, you can select language, country, etc. You can select the George Fisher pipe. Select the diameter. And it will, I have now selected, I was in the 3D view. What's going on? Let's see. And you can start designing the George Fisher piping systems again. As you can see here on the right, you have access to all the technical details. You can add some flows as well, which are open parameters. You'll find the diameter, system type, etc. You can design the system whatever you like, and the same goes here. You can change the diameters. And as you can see here, the coupling I just created, it is custom. So that means this option is not standard available in the George Fisher piping system. So Revit tells you, okay, hey, please be aware that it's not possible to have a reducing T from 75 diameter to 108. And so you know, okay, if I want to continue, I have to select another solution. Now, if I stick to 75, it of course knows. And also with this information, you'll see it will be added to the Revit schedule, the piping schedule, and the fitting schedule. And you will find all the technical details here, what the length is of the piping system, and so on. So via this way, it's very easy for engineers to design manufacturer-specific piping systems. You have access to all information, and it helps you in the design, in creating the Revit schedules. All relevant data is up to date and available. And it's also very important that manufacturers offer this kind of information to engineers, because as we all know, BIM is getting more important, and engineers need this information. So manufacturers, please be aware of that. And of course, we are always able, or we are always looking forward to help manufacturers with creating similar solutions like this. All right, we are coming to an end already, and we have a few final slides. Of course, the Map Content product line placer. All these apps are available at the Map Content website. You can go to mapcontent.eu or store.mapcontent.eu, and you can download the apps. You can get a free trial of the product line placer with the different manufacturers. You can download the Sona app, ABB app, and the Map Content app all for free. And we also would like to inform you that more manufacturers are coming up with on short notice, so soon you will have access to design sewage systems, for example, with similar product line placers from other manufacturers. I can't tell you the names yet, but keep an eye on the Map Content platform, and when a new application shows up, please feel free to take a look and give us feedback. As mentioned, it's a brand new way to expose products for manufacturers. We are cooperating with manufacturers, and we are thinking of good, suitable solutions to offer to map engineers. And of course, it is there's always a question from the manufacturer how he wants to offer the products or how he wants to offer his data. But it's also very important to listen to the engineers and what do they want? How do they want to design in Revit? And this kind of solutions are helping with that by offering a customized app. So some advantages for having an app like this available, it is that customers can easily draw localized data. As I have showed you, it's possible to select different countries, different languages, different sets of data, and it's very easy for manufacturers to have one application available and to reach globally all your customers. You can add languages yourself, and we do our best to make them available as well. It is a very easy way for engineers to design piping systems. As every BIM engineer might know, Revit has its limitations, and we believe with apps like this, we are increasing the work speed of engineers, and it's much easier to design a system than, for example, a Revit family pack, how it's also often done. Also mentioned, BIM engineers always draw or work with the right latest data. Because it's coming from the cloud, we make sure engineers always work with up-to-date content. And of course, for manufacturers, you get user statistics, so you get an idea of where the app is downloaded and where the people are working with your app. So also, you can create an account at MapContent. As soon as you've created this account, you can download the apps for free. You can download all the 530,000 articles for free. And I'd just like to invite you to take a look. Look for the manufacturers you're often using. And if you're missing manufacturers, please let me know, let us know. And we do our best to make these files available as well. We're coming to the end of this webinar. I would like to thank you already for having you. I hope this webinar was interesting for you and you've learned something new. If you have any questions, we will be here for another few minutes. And please feel free to ask them, or if you have a question afterwards, you can always reach us by phone or by email. And we looking forward to have contact with you and share ideas about the BIM topic. If you found it interesting and you would like to hear more and see more, we have a series of webinars. We had the webinar about content, we had the webinar about the product line placer, and the next webinar will also be about apps, but we will zoom into a different perspective. Please feel free to subscribe. You can find the download link on MapContent, or you will receive an email when we are getting close to the webinar. So hereby, Jaap and I would like to thank you for your attention, and please let us know if there are any questions. We have another question from one of the attendees. He's saying, with the product line placer, I get a pop-up because we already installed Stabicat. I can't use it. When you have installed Stabicat, you also have access to the product line sheets of Sana in this case. So the functionalities for designing with Sana are already in the Stabicat software. And so you don't need an application for that. But that's only for the Stabicat users. I hope this answers your question.